In this video, I'm gonna walk you step by step on how to set up your Twitch or your YouTube alerts inside of Ecamm. That way, when somebody follows or somebody subscribes, it pops up on screen. So the very first thing we're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna come to streamelements.com. I'll put a link in the description of this video. Once you're here, you're gonna select login, select Twitch or YouTube, whatever platform you're gonna be streaming to. If you are gonna be streaming to Twitch and YouTube, you're gonna have to do this for both platforms. You can't do it for one and it work for the other, so just keep that in mind. For this example, I'm gonna utilize Twitch. I'm going to get logged in. Once you're logged in, you'll be brought to a dashboard just like this. We'll come to the left-hand side, select streaming tools. We'll select overlays. We'll select new overlay. And now we'll select 1080p, hit start. And we're going to go ahead and name this Twitch alerts. We'll hit save. And now we want to select add widget. We're going to come to alerts. We're going to select alert box. And now me personally, I like to just keep the follow alert, the subscriber alert. I take the tip alert off, cheer, raid, and I take the purchase alert off. You can decide which ones you want to go ahead and utilize. Today, I'm going to show you how to set up a few of them as well as variations. And then you'll be able to follow the same process for all the others. So we're going to go ahead and select follow alert. We're going to select this little gear icon. And this is how we're going to go ahead and edit it. Now, by default, it does give you one generic kind of alert. So if I come here to emulate and hit follow, this is going to show the example of what's currently there. What I'm going to do is we're going to use custom alerts to make this look a little bit more professional. So for that example, I'm going to utilize streamdesigns.com. And again, I'll put a link in the description of this video. They have tons of professional overlays for you to make your stream look professional. So you have animated overlays, countdown timers, sync transitions, and animated alerts. Now, every single package does include alerts with it. So for example, I'm using the Zen Zone stream package. And you can see here that it's going to go ahead and include my alerts. However, you can go ahead and get alerts individually based on what you're looking for. So for this example, I'm going to utilize the Zen Zone alerts. And you're going to see here that's going to go ahead and give me my new subscriber, new donation, new follower, new member, new host, new bits, gifted sub, gifted membership, and super chat. And these are interchangeable. Some are for Twitch and some are for YouTube. So once you go ahead and get your alerts, and if you get your alerts from Stream Designs, it's going to download in a zip file. And then when you double click on that zip file, it's going to create a folder for you, giving you access to your overlays. So we'll come here. Once you have your overlays, we'll select change video. You'll then select upload and we'll find that file that we went ahead and downloaded from Stream Design. So first it's going to come in a folder just like this. Hit alerts. We're going to look for a new follower. And here it is, new follower. We'll hit open. That's going to bring it in. And then you want to bring in all your other overlays as well. Again, I'm going to show you this example. And then you'll be able to follow along for all the others. So we're going to hit submit. This is going to bring it in here. So now we're going to hit emulate. And you're going to see here that it's not going to be, the text is not where it needs to be. So we want to customize this, right? So the first thing is I like to go ahead and remove this and say name. And I like to do followed, right? The shorter we can keep it, the more we can compensate for longer names, etc. Right? So we have that there. Alert duration, I like to put it at 6 seconds. That's enough time for it to be on screen. I personally, you can keep the sound or you can clear the sound. I personally leave the sound off. Or if you do want to use any kind of sound effects, I typically lean into Epidemic Sound. I'll leave a description, a link in the description below, where you can get over 90,000 sound effects without having to worry about any copyright claims or so. But you can also find sounds anywhere you like. So then I'm going to come down here to the bottom. I'm going to click on text settings because we need to adjust this now. So the first thing we're going to do is for the size, I like to leave it at 30. You want to make sure this is centered. You want to make sure this is bold and that the text shadow is on. So again, we'll open this up, hit follower. You see that we now have just the name and follow. Now we need to get this centered here in the middle. And then you can put whatever color you want for the name. I like to leave it at white, or you can pick the color that matches your overlay that you went ahead and got. Then we're going to come to the top and we're going to select advanced. This is how we're going to get the name to show up in the middle. So typically what I like to do is I like to start at -150. And if you want it to go a little bit higher, you go negative up. So if I wanted to move the text higher, I would go -155. Or if I wanted to move it lower, I would go -145. So when I hit follower event, you're going to see here that it's a little bit too low. Okay. So I'm just going to grab this and I'm going to go and switch this to be 160. And we'll do this again. And now you can see that it's moved up. So it looks like the sweet spot is going to be 175. And that's going to be the center point there. I'm going to come back to text and I'm going to make this just a little bit bigger. And I'm going to maybe do 40, hit follower event. And you can see here that now I have the name centered exactly where I want it to be. I'm just going to hit save here for a moment. And now I'm going to show you what else you can do here with the variations, because this is going to be super important. So when you come here to subscriber alert, this is where it's going to change, because somebody can subscribe for 1 month, for 2 months, for 3 months. They may have resubscribed to you and you want to have different variations of alerts. This is how you would set this up. Setting up cheer, setting up raid is going to be exactly exactly the same. We set a follow alert. And once you understand the variation aspect of it, you can do it for the others as well. So let's go ahead and set up the subscriber alert. So we'll come to this little gear icon. Again, we're going to change the video. I'm going to go ahead and upload the subscriber one here. So we're going to come to new subscriber, hit open. I'm going to go ahead and select it, submit it there. I'm going to clear the sound, and then we'll come here and it says name, just subscribed. I like to go ahead and sub this down to just subbed. Okay. Again, it's just to keep it short. Duration is going to be 6 seconds, same process. And then we're going to scroll down and we're going to go to text settings. We're going to make this just a little bit bigger, maybe 35. We'll go to advanced. We're going to remember we got, like we did before, 175, and we're going to test it to be able to see. So here we are. It's centered exactly where we want it to be. And then here, the color, again, you can change it to be whatever color you want. I'm going to leave it at white. And here we have it here now, Bridget just subbed. Okay. So now what we want to do is we want to make sure that we make the variations that we need to be able to make. So we're going to come to settings. We're going to come to the subscriber alert, the little gear icon. And here you're going to see where it says variation settings. So we're going to click that. And you see here that we have three different variations. We have a resubscriber variation, a subscriber gift variation, and community gifts, right? So pretty much I go ahead, you can toggle these on, toggle this off, but I'm going to show you the process to set this up. Okay. So resubscriber, we're going to hit this little gear icon and we're going to follow the same process. If you don't change it here, it's not going to go ahead and change inside of StreamElements and it's not going to show up on your stream. So we'll hit change video. We'll select new subscriber the same way. We'll then go ahead and scroll down. We want to make sure that our alert duration is at 6 seconds. Then we're going to scroll down here and we're going to say that our text size is 35, advanced 175, and we're going to hit save variation. So then you can preview it and you can see here that this is out of line, right? Because it's going to be a lot bigger. So-and-so just resubscribed. So I want to go ahead back to the gear icon. Okay. And instead of resubscribed, I'm going to put resubbed for X amount of months. And then I'm going to scroll down here and I'm going to adjust this sizing and maybe put it at about 28 and hit save. And then we'll test this again. And now you can see here that everything is where it needs to be. And then you would do the same thing for subscriber gift if you choose to use it by just editing it. Community gifts, same thing if you want to choose and edit it. And that's how you would go ahead and create variations of your alert. So now with that, you can now go one by one and set up your subscriber alert, your cheer alert, and your rate alert, utilizing the alerts you got from Stream Designs. Now, once you've completed this, we now need to bring it into Ecamm. So to be able to do that, we're going to hit save. I encourage you to save after every change that you make. We're going to come to where this paperclip icon is. We're going to select it. See, it says copy to clipboard. And now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and come over to Ecamm. And inside of Ecamm, you're going to want to come to the screen where you're going to want to add your alert. So let's say, for example, I want to add it to my just chatting scene. So I'm here on my scenes and then I'll come to the right side where it says overlays. And again, if you don't see your overlays windows, just go to windows, click overlays, and you'll be brought to here. We're going to select this little world icon, which is the browser source. We're going to name this alert Zen Zone, and you can name this whatever you want. And then I'm going to double click here and I'm going to just paste the one, the link that we just got from Stream Elements. We're going to select here and we're going to go 1920 by 1080. We're going to select high resolution mode and we're going to select keep running. This is super important. Okay. We're going to then hit add widget overlay and you're going to see that now it's added. This is going to be our alert. So now in Stream Elements, what you want to be able to do is you want to go ahead and come to your alerts. You want to hit emulate and you want to hit the follow alert just a few times. So I would encourage you to click it at least 4 to 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we will come back here into Ecamm. And we'll see the alert pop up. And this is going to allow you to be able to go ahead and size it and put it exactly where you want it to pop up, right? So I have it there. I want it to pop up here on the left-hand side. So now we're good there. And you'll see that it starts to pop up. Now, when I get an alert, it's there. Now, if you want to add this to any other scene, all you need to do is click on it. Hit Command C on your keyboard to copy it. And then we can come to starting soon, click here, and now you can paste it. Okay. Then you hit Command V and it pastes right into the section. Now you can come back to Stream Elements, hit it a few more times, and now you can go ahead and adjust where exactly you want this alert to be able to be visible. And then you would do the exact same thing in every aspect of a scene that you want the alert to be able to show up. But if you want to know how to go ahead and add a countdown timer into Ecamm so you can build some hype for your stream, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on doing just that. I'll see you guys in the next video.